Hello friends, myself Professor Datta Prasad Gavi. I am from Brahmacharya Dada Mane Polytechnic, Belati, Solapur. Today I am going to deliver a lecture on fundamentals of estimating and costing. Having MSBT code 22503. Now before we are going to learn the subject estimating and costing, the learners should have to know the thorough knowledge of building constructions, building drawing and planning, designing, etc. So first of all, we see the definition of estimating. Estimating is the process to calculate the quantities of various items of civil engineering works. So in this subject we have to calculate the quantities of different items for every civil works. Okay, what are the purposes of estimation? So first of all, we have to know the cost calculation of the project. Then we have to find the time required for completion of the project. We have to make estimate. Third point, when we are going to found the cost of the project, we have to invite that work in terms of tenders. It is called as tender invitation. So when we are going to invite the tenders, after a complete or detailed estimation of civil engineering work, then expenses control. So while we are going to start one building for the execution purpose, then the number of expenditures or number of activities are going there. So for the various civil engineering activities, civil engineering or the owners must need the various cost to complete that work. So that work should be, or the cost of the work should be minimized or controlled by keeping in mind the estimating, right? Then matching our prepared plan with the funds means when we are going to develop an estimate for a particular project, then that estimated amount of that project is to be matches with the particular plan of that project. So these are the purposes for doing an estimate. Next point is the types of estimate. Basically the estimate is divided in two types. First one is approximate estimate and second one is detailed estimate. Approximate estimate is again divided in three parts: plinth area method, then cubical content method and typical wave method. So these are the three various methods we are going to adopt to calculate the approximate estimate. First of all, what is an approximate estimate? So approximate estimate, it is a type of estimate in that we are going to find the cost of item in a specific or in a short time duration. That is called as approximate estimate. So plinth area method, in this method we are going to calculate the estimate for a building having covered plinth, or the area of that building which is covered with the टेरेस और कवर्ड बालकनीज और कवर्ड गैलरीज और कवर्ड पोर्चेस. तो दीज कवर्ड एरिया आर टू बी कंसिडर्ड फॉर कैलकुलेशन बाय यूजिंग प्लिंथ एरिया मेथड. तो फॉर जस्ट टेक वन एग्जांपल ऑफ प्लिंथ एरिया मेथड. सपोज ए बिल्डिंग हैविंग साइज 5 मीटर्स बाय 10 मीटर्स, देन व्हाट इज द एरिया? 5 टू 10 50 मीटर स्क्वायर. सो द प्लिंथ एरिया इज 50 मीटर स्क्वायर एंड exceeding to that 50 meter square, those areas which are covered by the slab, that area also we have to consider for plinth area calculation of approximate estimate. Then cubical content method. So in this method, the building cost is calculated by using volume of building into rate per unit of building. So this is the very simple method to calculate a approximate estimate. We have to just apply one formula, that is volume of building into rate per unit. Then typical bay method. So this is also called as unit bay method. That is based on the units of that particular building. So in this method, the building is divided into similar number of bays. Once we are knowing the size of one bay, then we have to automatically multiply with the number of bays. Then we get the cost of that structure. So cost of that structure equal to number of units or number of bays into unit rate per bay or unit rate per structure, right? So these are the various types of approximate estimate. Then going to detailed estimate. So detailed estimate requires drawings, specification and rates. So the drawings, which are those drawings? Drawings includes plan, sectional drawings, elevation with all necessary dimensions and the details of the drawings. That is the working drawings. Then specifications required. So there are two basic types of specification: general specification and detailed specification. So in the general specification, the nature of work, quantity of work and class of work to be considered for completion of particular item of work. It is called as general specification. And in the detailed specification, we are going to know the quality, type and the quantity of material which is used to complete the work. So all these specifications we have to consider for calculation of detailed estimate. Then third point is the rates. So how the rate is applied for finding the detailed estimate? First one is unit rate of items, means one particular unit, that is excavation is a one item, then that item per unit rate, means the excavation quantity is calculated in terms of meter cube. So the rate of excavation is amount per meter cube, that is unit rate of item. Then material rates, then transportation cost, labor and wages, labor and their charges. So the labor charges are different according to their class or type of labor, that is skilled labor, unskilled labor, mason, carpenter, etc. So all the three points to be considered for calculation of detailed estimate. So the requirement of detailed estimate. For calculation of detailed estimate, an engineer should have to know these two forms, that is called as measurement sheet and abstract sheet. So that part is we are discussing in the next.